China, September 21st, 2025. The largest flood of the year roared in, forcing the Three Gorges Dam to urgently release water, drowning downstream villages in a sea of water. On September 21st, 2025, it felt as if China had stepped into a never-ending nightmare, where nature unleashed fury with rains tearing the sky apart, monster typhoons roaring offshore, mountains collapsing without warning, and even the solid ground cracking open to swallow vehicles. Yet the center of fear this time was the colossal Three Gorges Dam, once a source of pride as the world's greatest hydroelectric project, now forced into emergency discharge as it faced the year's biggest flood. All of this unfolded as monstrous storms closed in on southern China's coastlines, threatening a chain reaction of disasters never seen before. On September 21st, the Three Gorges Reservoir faced torrents from upstream rushing down at over 40,000 cubic meters per second, a terrifying volume enough to drown an entire city if it escaped control. Throughout summer, inflows into the dam had been 20% lower than average, giving a false sense of relief that the flood season might pass lightly. But at the very end of the season, relentless downpours from western China merged into the Jialing River and the upper Yangtze, forming a colossal flood wave charging straight at the dam. Under such immense pressure, the dam's management company was forced to increase discharge, lowering the water level to 162.6 meters to ease the load, while keeping release at 25,300 cubic meters per second, the maximum the hydroelectric plant could withstand. Though deemed necessary to prevent a dam break, this decision meant downstream regions had to brace for raging torrents at any moment. As China struggled to process the news from Three Gorges, the South China Sea boiled with storms that quickly intensified into super typhoons. On the morning of September 21st, Typhoon Havoc was classified as Category 17 by the Central Meteorological Observatory. Winds near 60 meters per second, powerful enough to rip away everything in its path. Havoc was not alone. Other storms with nightmare-like names, Bhattacharya, Kasa, Hawajisha, Hyacinth, Hakata, were swirling together, trailing one another across weather charts. Guangdong, one of China's most populous and bustling regions, issued a rare warning: prepare for massive disasters ahead. Guangdong Provincial Meteorological Bureau forecasts from September 23rd to 25th, the entire coast would be hammered by force 16 winds, torrential rains, surging seas, and widespread flooding. The most frightening scenario was multiple landfalls, with storms skimming the coast instead of dissipating, stretching impacts over wider and longer areas. People in Guangdong now feared not only roofs being ripped off or streets drowned, but also the possibility of tornadoes and violent storms striking even areas outside the typhoon's core. All vessels were ordered back to port immediately, while on land, authorities repeatedly warned of flash floods, landslides, and mudslides, common killers when storms collide with mountainous terrain. In this bleak landscape, eastern China was equally battered. In Zhejiang, torrential rain overnight turned Wenzhou into a miniature ocean. Arterial roads sank under floodwaters. Cars floated helplessly like toys in the current. underground parking lots, once considered safe shelters for hundreds of vehicles, were swallowed by filthy torrents within minutes, leaving residents devastated as their property was ruined beyond recovery. Many compared the scene to the infamous Golden Mountain flood of the past, a nightmare now reborn. Meanwhile, Yunnan's mountains began to collapse. On September 20th, a sudden landslide struck Highway G247 in Yanjin County, burying vehicles beneath cascades of rock and soil. Miraculously, passengers escaped, but the incident chilled the spine of everyone who saw it. A single slide could erase lives in seconds. Traffic froze for hours before emergency crews cleared the road. Authorities had no choice but to issue warnings, urging drivers to remain on high alert when passing steep slopes. If mountains rebelled, even the ground itself was restless. On the afternoon of September 20th, Joku City in Henan Province was shaken by a sudden road collapse at a busy intersection. In an instant, a section of pavement the size of a small house caved in nearly 2 meters deep, swallowing 3 vehicles including a car and a garbage truck. Panic erupted as crowds fled, but luckily those inside managed to escape. By nightfall, rescue teams sealed off the area for investigation, while residents trembled at the thought of hidden sinkholes waiting to open beneath their feet. On the night of September 21st, tension grew as the Henan Natural Resources Bureau, along with the Provincial Meteorological Office, issued a yellow warning for geological hazards. More than 25 counties and cities, including Zhengzhou, Luoyang, and Xuchang, faced high risks of landslides and mudslides within 24 hours. People were urged to prepare for sudden evacuation, as a single prolonged downpour could send mountains crashing down and sweeping everything away. Looking at this relentless chain of events over just a few days, it became clear that nature had unleashed total fury upon China. Floods at the Three Gorges, super typhoons in Guangdong, rain and inundation in Zhejiang, landslides in Yunnan, and earth splitting open in Henan. In these days, Chinese citizens had no choice but to cling to weather reports, hoping for a sliver of good news. That rains would stop, storms would fade, and floods would recede. Yet above them, storms still howled, dense clouds still gathered, and beneath them, the earth still trembled with unseen dangers. China now seemed trapped in a life and death gamble with nature, and the price to pay could be tragedies beyond anyone's imagination.